So far, just under half of all the crypto and fiat from the South Korean exchanges that closed down last month has been recovered, converted to fiat, and withdrawn through banks or transferred to other exchanges, but one US dollar. 8 meters still remains unaccounted for 2 weeks post-shutdowns. As previously reported, scores of exchanges were forced to close on September 25 after the nation imposed some of the strictest rules in the world on trading platforms. They were forced to obtain Information Security Management System, ISMS, certification from the government's IT agency in order to offer crypto-to-crypto trading, and real name-authenticated banking service partners if they also wanted to offer fiat trading. Of this number, the Segye Ilbo reported, 13 platforms tried to obtain ISMS certification, but failed to do so, and thus were forced to close. Per figures from the Financial Intelligence Unit, FIU, a total of $3.5 million worth of fiat and coins had been held on these platforms. But now, over 2 weeks later, only $1.76 million has been recovered. The media outlet pointed out that some exchanges had experienced server issues that have caused delays. But the FIU could be set to tackle a much thornier problem, namely planned bankruptcies, whereby companies attempt to use the legal system to declare themselves unable to refund their customers. No such bankruptcies have yet been reported to the financial authorities, but the fact that so much crypto and fiat still remains unclaimed or unrefunded will be a major cause for concern. A total of 36 exchanges closed down completely on September 25, including the aforementioned 13 that had failed to obtain ISMS certification.